mortals must be shown the order of things.
Hey guys, we're in a game here. Obviously. We're against a Zeus player. So I keep thrashing the question is, do I mulligan armaments? Most of the time Zeus players have something to play, so I think the answer is no. Venator, of course, is excellent. So do I actually play Venator first? In a sense, Venator is actually harder to play because it gets Thanatosed. So we're going to play the Venator here. Move blown up. This way, it can't be attacked by the Zeus. But I should be able to hit almost anything he plays, unless it's 1-2. Unless it's here. If he judgments it, that's pretty good for me. Because late game, I've got big cards that he's going to want a judgment. If he runs away, that's fine. I figured he would play something, so I played it really far back, but maybe I should have played it up. It's possible that it was incorrect, the placement. I should have played it up. I would have played it here. Or here. Probably here. If he doesn't move his Zeus, that's fine, because I'll get 3 free damage. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Cool. I'll hit a Zeus. Speckensy speaker. Okay. I could remove Doom Speaker. I could get more value to Mercenary though. And I think it's just Ascentius. So we move you here so that you have the passive so that you can attack the Zeus, no return damage. And now I move Bellona up and play Ascentius. There's some reason to auto into Zeus so that if he Spartans, then I can still kill him. But he should feel pretty obligated to remove that Ascentius. Is this guy. If he doesn't, he gets a lot of value with Cleave. Cleave is pretty disgusting. Is he going to judge with that thing finally? Okay. And he had that earlier too, so he just like hard misplayed. He took 3 damage for no reason. Okay. That's fine. It still dies. So since he moved there, 1, 2, 3, this now hits. Oh, wow, right, that kills him. I'm smart. I can do math. Really wasn't very hard math either. All right, so retreat a little bit and stick that there. I still want to play up. I've got enlist next turn. So this wants to trade into that, and then I enlist whatever he spawns on 5. It usually has a lot of health. Next turn, I have to be wary of Athena. Discovery God. If he gets Soul, Soul wouldn't be horrible. He could clear the 2-5 with that. But he would have to trade in 3-2, so he kind of doesn't want to trade in the 3-2. It's a trade I want to make. Like, even if he buffs him, that's fine. He has a 3-1, but still dies. If he moves the Zeus into the corner, that'll be great. Please do that. So there is an argument to enlist this, so that I can kill the Zeus. But I kind of just want to buff that card. I don't know what he Midased, but it was 4 mana or more. There are quite a few gods that are 4 mana or more. He's going to have a lot of trouble dealing with the Ascensius. I'm just going to hold FG, I think. Actually, no, that's incorrect. I should play it very aggressively. If he gets board control back at this point, won't really matter. I don't think he will. And FG kind of just auto wins board control. So when he moved to Zeus in the corner, he made it really easy for me to kill. Yeah, alright. Puts it at 4 so I can kill that character. Got 6 mana. So we're gonna hero ability. Chaos spawn, it doesn't matter. Mercenary for a 3-5. Whack you. Move Bellona, then whack the stone. It's not a trade I want to make. I want him to make that trade. I am nicely situated for another Athena. I'm willing to take that chance. So I missed killing a 3-4, basically. That's 5. Okay, well, but Bellona, that's also 5. And 2. Well, that's 3. So then it would be Cupid. If I I demoralize. They do have healing. I think it dies next turn either way. I'm gonna play the Cupid mostly for the damage to this top stone. Not so much for killing the Athena. Yeah, I think that was correct. Because then if he Thanatos is the Cupid, then at least he gets something in return. Argus. Okay. I still have Enlist, so the Enlist goes to the Argus most likely. Most likely, the 2-2 goes into the stone, the 3-2 goes into the 5-5, Enlist goes on to the 5-2. Cupid's hitting there. You're hitting there.
I sense a battle approaching. Let us hope our
unfortunately, my vendor spawned all the way back. There, I should have spawned Bologna first, so that I had a chance to spawn up. If he removes the 2-2, that's great for me. That's fine. I could just kind of push into this top stone here. I am kind of on a bit of a clock unless I draw armaments. So perhaps it should be a 2 of, not a 1 of. I'll have to consider it. What would I cut? Oh shoot, I haven't had my deck up this entire time. My bad.
I bring the start of a new Ragnarok.
Oh, do you know? Well, there's the unit you got from Touch of Midas. I've not been watching where his cards are coming from either. Oh, hey there, Sylvanas. I don't think I play on this turn. But you're going in there. You are moving up. Hero ability. Enlist. Now I've just got to deal with Loki. Which is fine because I've got 2/3 attack minions. I think I do save FG now that I've lost a little bit of push. We'll see. I'd rather play Sylvanas than FG.
Now to find a soulmate.
Oh hey fam. Yet I'm glad the flappy wings go away. Ah, blessed silence. Six mana could be scary. Baboon. Fair enough. Ah, Rain of Arrows. How good to see you. Is it actually, though? Might actually be correct to not play it. Let's see, what are my two options? So, Hero Power Sylvanas, and I put Sylvanas. Where? Well, these guys are moving up. That's 100%. Hero Power Sylvanas goes. Where? He's already played both Athenas. Probably here to play around Hades. He doesn't have a leader on board either. I think still here. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, it's pretty good. The other one is Rain of Arrows. I think Hero Power Sylvanas is actually better.
Good morning, Wilma. Time to get up. This forest needs our protection. That's the spirit.
Okay. Neck and Rain of Arrows. Another day. I think developing the 5-6 is more valuable than poking a 3-7 down to poking that down to a 3-4. Because the 5 damage trades into it better. Does that, I'm very happy because I can just kill Aphra with Bellona. I mean, even if he removes it, that's fine. I'm still going to do damage to it, and I would have had to trade it in anyway. And the Nike's going to die, obviously. But this allows me to Rain of Arrows 3-4 as well, if I desire. Depends on what he plays.
Today I fight not for Olympus, but for myself. Okay. These immortals
must armaments.
Be shown the order of things.
You're trading in there. You need to be in range of stone. You're killing Nike. You're moving up.
Just something I whipped up.
Okay, so I don't get to choose where to spawn that. Wasn't sure about that. Well, he surrenders, and he was probably going to lose that. So, GG.